This is a smart and automated system.
Okay, we designed this project mainly for elderly and disabled people, whereby they can switch on or switch off in mobile using a smartphone via Bluetooth. Like what my colleague is doing here, switching on plants, switching on
the appliance.
Switching on.
Okay, it's nice.
It has a range of 10 to 100 meters.
Oh, so you just use Bluetooth?
Yes.
To
use Bluetooth.
So you designed a software?
Yeah, there's a software.
You designed it yourself?
No.
You just
download. Oh, you download the software, but you designed this one.
I designed this one.
Okay. Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
I didn't get your names.
I'm Ignatius Mparutsa.
Okay. I'm Absalom Ganda.
Okay. Take power. Coca Cola. 2018.
Thank you.
Hashtag.
Nice.
Thank you.
Like, moving on here. Yeah. How are you, gentlemen?
How are you, sir?
I'm okay.
We just see we have a mosquito repellent device.
Okay.
This device uses ultrasound to repel mosquitoes. But right now we have adjusted the frequency for it to be audible to the human ear.
Okay.
But on normal operations, the sound is silent to the human ear using 30 kilohertz.
Okay, so it's used to.
It only repels them.
To repel. Okay.
It does not kill them.
So the noise will just chase them out.
Yeah, the noise chases them. It takes.
So how much can I get this one?
Right now we are looking at the price of $26 to $30.
$26.50.
Okay. So it uses electricity or batteries?
It's powered. It's powered.
Batteries.
Okay.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Your names?
My name is Godfrey Mkena.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Right.
Now irrigating. Stops irrigating.
Sorry, I didn't get it. It stops. Okay. So what type of crops need continuous irrigation? Where can we use this? What type of crops can you use?
We can use on crops that need more water, like sugarcane, bananas.
Okay. Thank you, guys. Your names? I didn't get your names.
I'm Chris Brandy, and my colleague is Ezra Chipo.
Okay, thank you.
Another win.
Okay, this is our project titled Generator Oil Fuel Level Monitoring System. All it does is monitor the levels of fuel and oil in a generator.
Assume this is a fuel tank, this is the oil tank, and this is our display unit. As you can see right now, the green light is on. When the green light is on, it indicates that our tank is full. When it is on amber like this, it shows that our tank is halfway down. When our tank is almost empty, it shows a red light and produces a sound which will alert the attendant to go and refuel. You can also take this display unit in your office, and the transformer or the generator might be a distant away, so you will be visualizing on the display that your fuel is running low or your oil is running low in a transformer or in a generator.
Okay,
so that's all our project.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. Saka zvakamira sei?
This is a color sorting machine whereby it is using machines where it goes out and videos large scale production. So this machine is used to differentiate products with different colors. How does it do it? Well, let's say we have three different products, right? One color blue, green and red. What if a blue color comes or a green color comes? Let's say a green comes. So when the green comes, sure, its color shall be detected as you are seeing here.
Okay.
As it's been detected, it shall be directed to its right compartment. Okay? And also the red one, as it comes, its color is being detected as you are seeing. And also directed to its right compartment. Lastly, as we are seeing also the blue one being directed to its right side.
So basically
this is how the machine works.
Okay. So you said it's called a what?
Color sorting machine.
Oh, color sorting. It's used in where can we use this machine?
Mostly in production.
Where we might be producing goods like bathing soaps. They come in different colors.
Okay.
So you need to separate them according to colors, whereby the blue colors should be going in there.
Right
compartment, the green in the other compartment, the red one, the other one compartment.
Okay.
So basically this is how it is.
Okay, I thank you gentlemen.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
So
good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, guys.
With my partner here, Lindwin Pamir, representing to you the fire alarm system. Basically for home alarming, it uses a smoke sensor in the buzzer to alarm in case fire, then an LED just in case this LED is for circuit that it indicates that the circuit is being powered, then this indicates that there's fire and so let me adjust it exactly this way. Then then it will take time to turn on the buzzer so as to compensate burning pots and candles, but if this smoke and fire insists, then the buzzer will turn on and the red light to indicate that there's smoke or fire, something is danger.
Okay. Yeah, thank you, guys.
You're welcome.
Okay. Action.
Alright. My name is Jason Chasa and my colleague here, Elliot Bombe, and I'm presenting on the automatic tobacco burn dryer. So on this burn dryer, this is our burn, like, and this one is our control unit. We have some heaters, a couple of heaters inside the burn, and you have the fan for heat distribution. So the fan here is for heat distribution. Our temperature sensor, we use the thermostat at the back of the burn there. So I will leave this time to Elliot to demonstrate how it works.
Okay.
You start the burner here, and this light is for indication to show that our heaters are operating. Our heaters are there. And the fan is blowing some heat for heat distribution inside the burner. So if the temperature is reached, this light will go off just to show that the heaters are switched off. In fact, if it drops down, the heaters will automatically kick on again.
Okay, so it's automatic?
Yes, it's automatic.
Okay. Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you.
So the moment you have a gas leakage like this, this is our sensor, we'll have the something for sorry. Okay. The moment this is the detect gas leakage, it will trigger the bus and the bus will warn you.
Okay.
So you check action.
Alright. So gas leakage, where can you use this?
This is for domestic use, industrial use, wherever you are having gas.
Okay.
You can just implement use of gas sensor. Then it detects all the leaks.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, you can start.
Alright, guys, we are showcasing in the hospital emergency alert system. Right? This project is based on the rapid communication between the ward in the hospital and the reception of the hospital. Right? We are assuming that this is a big hospital where we can have more than 100 wards, more than that. Mm. So that if you are in one of them, right, and you need anything, can be medical attention, can be whatever you want, right? You can move around the whole hospital looking for a nurse or something, right?
Yeah.
And what you do with this system is that you need to just press a button, right? Mm. And sit next to your bed, and then you receive attention.
Okay.
But it goes like this. If I'm in the ward, right, and I press the button that I need something, the indicators on top of the ward come in also at the reception, right?
Okay.
But the person at the reception is in charge of sending you the next doctor.
Right.
But if the person here does not see the indicator in time, the siren also come in, indicating that definitely there's a need of something in the ward.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Now, what happened here? By that, the patient at the reception cannot switch off the indicators. The patient at the reception cannot switch off the indicators.
Okay, not switch off.
Can't switch off the indicators.
Okay.
The indicators are being switched off at the ward after attending the ward.
The okay.
The patient. The ward.
Okay.
So this is basically what happened in this. If you got any questions, just ask.
Yeah, I know, it's a nice project. Thank you so much.
Welcome.